Check me out, I'm in Minecraft in VR!
What's up, Flob? Today, I'll be showing you how to get Minecraft on your Oculus Quest headset. So a few things you'll need for this video is, of course, your Quest headset, a Type-C to USB cable, and a PC or laptop. And then you will also need to have the Minecraft Java Edition purchased on your Microsoft account. I would also like to mention that Questcraft is not on the official Oculus store yet, so the game is still in the works, it's not perfect, and the loading times do take a while, so you're going to need patience. With all that said, let's get into it. First thing you need to do is set up a developer account. So go to oculus.com, log into your account, and then click on the first link I listed in the description below. That's going to take you to the developer mode setup. Now, if you've already done this and you have developer mode activated, you can go ahead and skip this step, just go to the next timestamp. To sign up as a developer, you need to choose an organization name. You can put whatever name you want, it doesn't really matter, whatever makes you happy at night. And then obviously read everything before you say you understand. You don't need to just, you know, blindly follow what somebody on the internet tells you, know what you're doing, read everything, be informed, and then agree. Now that we signed up as a developer, get your device that has your Oculus app on it and go to the menu and then devices and scroll down to developer mode and make sure that it is turned on. Okay, next up is Sidequest. That's the second link in the description below. That's gonna take you to the download. Again, if you've already done Sidequest and you have an account, skip to the next timestamp. Go ahead and download Sidequest. Once Sidequest is downloaded, go ahead and launch the application and create an account. All right, next up, let's break out the headset so we can get it connected to Sidequest. So plug your cable into your PC or laptop and hook it into your Quest. You should get a pop-up window to allow USB debugging. You're gonna hit allow, access files, one more. You should show connected on Sidequest. Go to the search bar and type in Questcraft. Select the game and hit the download app. You should see it installing in the bottom right. And when the tasks are completed, you'll see it in the bottom left. Okay, now we're gonna launch Questcraft. So to launch Questcraft, we're gonna go to apps in the bottom, all up at the top, and unknown sources, and then Questcraft. It's gonna clearly load a bunch of stuff. Just let it do its thing. All right, now we're gonna need to log into your Microsoft account. Once you've logged in, if you have the Keep Me Logged In checked, then you can hit Select Account and it'll let you choose your account the next time you launch. Okay, now we need to go to Versions here, scroll all the way down to Fabric Loader, and then go to Settings, Video and Render, Render, and make sure the third option is selected. Then we're gonna hit Play. So when this warning pops up, we're always gonna hit Play anyway, every time we launch. Your game should start loading right away, but if you get this pop-up or if your game or your headset itself is acting laggy, close the game and restart your headset. Also, check my pinned comment in case we find any extra issues. You'll get these three little dots on the screen, and you're just gonna have to sit and let them continue. Mine took about 1 to 2 minutes, felt like forever, but you're just gonna have to be patient. Then you'll get a red screen. And again, you're just gonna sit there and wait for it to finish. And now boom, we've loaded in. I noticed that it looks a little weird when you first load into the loading screen. And the menu is actually behind you, which is kind of weird. So what we're gonna do now is, it's a little awkward to reach, but you're gonna have to try and highlight reset. Okay, great. Now that we've done that, it's optimized the platform. So then you can launch however you want. You can do single player, multiplayer. I'm just gonna do single and make a new world, create world. And then again, it's gonna look like your game is crashing. It's gonna like be torn everywhere and it's gonna be frozen, but you just have to sit there and wait for it. Mine did take, again, like 1 to 2 minutes before it loaded in. Like I said before, the game isn't perfect. It does take a while.
A few moments later.
Still waiting. I got a red screen again, and now I'm loading the terrain. Check me out, I'm in Minecraft in VR. I have no sound. So I noticed when I loaded into my world, I didn't have any sound. So I closed out of Questcraft, restarted my headset, and then went back into the game, and now I have sound. So if any of you have that same problem, just restart your headset. And now we're mining. Oh yeah, all that sound. So much Minecraft sound. So So there you have it. You've now sideloaded Questcraft successfully, hopefully, onto your Quest headset, and you can now play Minecraft in VR. So if this video was helpful to you, I would appreciate a thumbs up on the video. If it wasn't helpful, let me know in the comments below. I'll do my best to help you troubleshoot. I went ahead and linked in the description the official Questcraft YouTube channel. It's one of the developers who's made the game, and they have some other resources on their YouTube channel to show you how to add mods, other resources, and like port your worlds. So if you wanted to port your Minecraft world, you can go to that YouTube channel that I linked in the description to find out how to do that. So happy mining, have fun.